morning, children. This is the last part of Geography Chapter 3, Weather and Climate. In our previous online classes, we read about the elements of weather and climate and how they are measured. Today, we will read the remaining elements of weather and climate and how they are measured. So, rainfall. Rainfall or precipitation is always measured using rain gauge. It is expressed in centimeter or millimeter. It is placed in an open area and below the ground so that only 30 centimeter of it remains above the ground. Why is it placed in an open area? So that it ensures that any splashes of water do not cause the rain gauge to collect extra water. And it is always placed only 30 centimeter remains above the ground so that it prevents evaporation of water. So let's see how rain gauge looks like and how it works. This is the diagrammatic representation of a rain gauge. You can see that this measures the amount of rainfall. You can see that it consists of a metallic cylinder and with a vessel inside it, and on the top a funnel is placed, and there is a gratitude jar which collects the rainwater. The rainwater is poured in this measuring jar using this funnel, and the reading is taken at an interval of 24 hours. Sunshine. In a meteorological station, sunshine duration is recorded by the sun dial. It is an instrument showing the time by the shadow of a pointer cast by sun onto a plate marked with hours of day. It means that it was the earliest type of time keeping device. It tells the time of a day by the position of a shadow, by position of shadow of some object. When exposed to sun rays, it forms a shadow, and sundial tells the time of the day by the shadow of that object. On maps, places having equal sunshine duration are joined by isohills. It is a line on a map which connects point having the same duration of sunshine. Now, wind speed and direction. So how are they measured? What are the factors that affect the direction of wind? We have already discussed this in our earlier videos. The pressure, rotation of the earth, friction or obstacle. The uneven heating of the earth causes pressure. It causes high pressure or low pressure. And wind always attract towards low pressure from high pressure region. So, wind blows from high pressure to low pressure region. Now, rotation of the earth, the earth rotates at different speed at the equator. And this difference in speed of rotation causes Coriolis force, which tends to change the direction and speed of wind. I have already discussed with you this in the previous videos. So, let's see the instruments. Wind direction instrument used for determining wind direction, wind van or weather cock. So wind van, it should be erected in an open position to get the accurate picture. It should be kept in an open position so that we get the accurate picture. This is the diagrammatic representation of a wind van. Okay, you can see that there's an arrow. This part of arrow is on the top of the pole, which is free to move with the prevailing wind. So the wind catches the tail of the arrow and swings the arrow to the direction from which this wind is blowing. And this part is stationary and it shows the cardinal direction, that is north, east, west and south. So we can say that winds are also named according to the direction. Like for example, we can say that wind blowing from the west are called as westerlies wind. Now wind speed is measured by anemometer, and this is the diagrammatic representation of an anemometer. So anemometer, how it works, you can see that it has four semicircular cups that are fixed to a rotating shaft, which is with the help of a thin rod, and so the movement of wind causes the cups to spin, and the inward curve of the cup receives the maximum force of the wind, and a metal attached at the base records the number of spins through which we measure the speed of the wind. It is always measured in kilometer per hour, knots or knots. Isotherms and isoheads. Isotherms, these are line joining places having equal temperature. Isothermal map shows the distribution of temperature over an area. Isotherms helps us to predict the weather of the next few days. Isoheads, these are imaginary lines joining places with the same amount of rainfall over a unit of time. Rainfall is always depicted on map to show seasonal distribution and variation across region. You can see the diagram which is given in your book on page 42 and 43. Okay, children, thank you. In the next video, I will upload the question answers and exercise. Go through the video and thank you.